Red light going on. Should catch them here at any moment in the last of the day. Racing now. And Demeritorious was sluggishly away. Comparative also missed it. So did Vega Dior, who's back there. City Star, Saxy Philly, Sordello. And also out quickly is Vital Asset, the Black Watch, going up there just in front of St. Bill. Getting one off Vega Dior soon after. Fontaine's War around it. Down on the inside of those, Comparative and a length to Viamo. Classy Survivor, Ultra Sillimore pushing up near the middle. And then Demeritorious back in the field, looking great. Hit Tune. And towards the tail end of the field is 2IC. 650 to go. The grey Saxy Philly leads the way from Vital Asset. On the rails then, City Star third, the Black Watch three wide, then Sordello, one St. Bill in the lime green. Vega Dior getting around its heels ahead of Fontaine's War. Comparative going up just behind them and travelling into it. Will Classy Survivor down near the inside. Viamo followed by Ultra Sillimore, 2IC, and wide out looking great. They're homeward bound at the 300. Saxy Philly joined on the outside now by the Black Watch, City Star, St. Bill, Sordello coming down the outside with Vega Dior as well at the 100 mark. Many hopes. Vega Dior is starting to lift. Look at Vega Dior. Classy Survivor got through on its inside though. Classy Survivor drove through on the rails and got there in the last. Classy Survivor from Vega Dior. And close up is Sordello, wide out looking great. Ultra Sillimore, City Star, look at them. They're all across the track from Saxy Philly, the Black Watch, Comparative Viamo, then Fontaine's War, Hit Tune, well back, 2IC pulling up back there in the field in company with Vital Asset and Demeritorious. Classy Survivor gets home. Number 14, Jess Eaton, the Vic, gets one up. She got beaten in the National Jockeys Challenge, but she's got home in the last. First winner at Ascot there. Vega Dior loomed as the winner, but it was Classy Survivor that got there at the end of the day, with Sordello, City Star splitting at almost a dead heat for third placing in front of Saxy Philly. It's 14, 13 and 12. The numbers all low down the order, and 4. 14, 13, 12 and 4. 1-12-4-4. The final race for the day, 36.34, that sectional time. So the winner, a mare by Discoursey, from Class of Her Own, for Mrs. J. Rowan, Dar McCaffrey, G. Dixon, M. Merson, D. Spector, Ern Cooley, R. Hewitt, N. Tibbles, and also A. Panowich, trained by Steve Rowe and written by the visiting Victorian rider in Jess Eaton. $20.90. Oh, she cut the corner there. She got a lovely run through between horses as Vega Dior wound up there and was coming. And just fleetingly, the gap might have been half closing, but Eaton drove Classy Survivor through. Vega Dior down the outside. Classy Survivor prevails just a little too good. And margins are a long neck by one length and a nose there to the last on the card. Steve Rowe has almost run down to the winner's enclosure. And as he composes himself, he catches up with Gareth Hall after the victory of Classy Survivor. And the Victorian visitor gets home in the last. Gareth.
Yeah, it's great to see, and well done to Jess Eaton. She won't forget this day, riding a winner here at Ascot. And Stephen Rowe does a really good job with his team. He's got a wonderful strike rate, and this was a good performance by Classy Survivor today. She turned up to the races with the bar plates on, and she's done the trick here.
Yeah, mate, she's a handful to work with, this horse. At home, her little nickname is the Devil. Whenever something goes wrong, we always say the Devil made me do it. She was an orphan foal, and her mum died at 3 days old, and the lady that reared her for us done a wonderful job, but unfortunately spoiled her rotten, and she thinks she's a bit of a human, to be honest. But she has had a little bit of a foot abscess, hence the reason for the bar shoe. It was very, very deep-seated, and it blew out through the frog, so I think it may have been hindering her for the entire prep, this prep in, so... I'm quite surprised that she won, because she's really missed a fair bit of work over the past 3 weeks to get this foot right. But it just vindicates our thoughts that she does have a little bit of ability, and it was really good for all the owners and all the people that have had patience to see this horse win today.
And that's great, I guess, for a trainer to have owners that do have patience, and sometimes if you have patience, days like this can happen.
Yeah, exactly. You know, if they, I think it's the old story. If you're allowed to be left alone and do your job, you'll do your job far better than if you've got people that want to try and tell you what to do. I think Bart Cummings one day came up with the best theory. If you want to help me train, it's $200 a day. If you leave me alone, it's $110.
And Jess Eaton, the Victorian jock, you put her on here today?
Yeah, look, a marvellous ride, you know. I've only just met the young lady about 5-10 minutes ago. She was very assertive when I spoke to her. We asked her to try and find a little plan, and I couldn't believe that she'd done it so well. She got the horse, spun off the fence, coming into the straight, you know, got along to the Dulux and done a marvellous job and just done everything terrific for us.
Well done, Roy.
Thank you.
There's Stephen Rowe, the winning trainer with Classy Survivor. Vega Dior was pretty good. She did look like the winner first up, but she just probably just died on a run just a little bit, and Sordello was back in third. Brittany Taylor's about to catch up with the Victorian Hoop in Jess Eaton, and as we just pointed out, Brittany, it's a day that I don't think she'll ever forget. She'll have to get onto the scales before you have a chat to Jess, but it was an 11 out of 10 ride by the Vic.
I tell you what, this has been a fantastic day for Jess. She's had three rides. The first of them paid about $25, $30 and she finishes second. The next ride paid $10 and she finishes second. All outside chances. And then you've just booted home the $20 winner. Congratulations, Jess. What a visit to WA.
Yeah, definitely. It's my first Metropolitan winner, so another big thrill on top of that.
Oh, and in a different state. That is absolutely amazing. Congratulations to you. Tell us about the run. Were you confident that you were going to get the split in the concluding stages?
Yeah, look, we wanted to be a bit further forward, but there was too much speed, and I thought I was better get her comfortable in travelling. It's a pretty tight gap she took, so full credit for the horse for having the confidence to take it, but she was really good. She was nice and strong.
And for those that don't know you in the West, tell us a little bit about yourself. When did you first start riding?
Started riding, race riding 3 years ago. I was unlucky and had an injury. I was out for a year, but going really well at the moment, and based with John and Chris Meyer in Mornington.
Well, you have ridden fantastically all day today. We'll have you anytime in the West. Congratulations, Jess.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.